Very good morning, children. Today I am going to take up a short composition, notice writing for students of class 11th and 12th. I know that you have been writing notices since class 6th and you are quite familiar with the format of writing notice. But as this question is given in the board examination, so it is one of the important topics of the writing skills. So I would be taking up today, and I hope you all concentrate and learn about what is notice writing. I would like to begin with, what is notice exactly, children? I would like to tell you, it is a short piece of writing, you know, through which we give information regarding the announcement of events, celebrations, occasions, or any other important information. Okay, children? Now, they are type of circulars. But what is the difference between a circular and a notice? Is only a minor difference. That difference is, a circular reaches through a messenger, whereas the notice, it is displayed either on a notice board of an organization or it is published in a newspaper column. Got it? So what is a notice? It is similar to a circular. See, why do the circulars are provided to the students in the school? To provide certain important information through which the students as well as the parents can go through and get, you know, information about what is going to take place in the school, or what is so important that the parents need to know, children. So, okay, now I would like to tell you, notice is generally written in a simple language. It is written briefly and to the point. Okay, notices are also published in newspapers and magazines, or they are displayed publicly on the notice board of any organization. So, got it, children? What is a notice? Once again, it is a short piece of writing. Why do we write a notice? To announce or to inform the public, the community, the members of the, you know, official staff or the students in the school regarding the various events that are going to be held, the celebrations that are going to be organized, or the various types of occasions like the sports day or maybe the annual function in the school. They can be any sort of celebration, or it can even be an important piece of information. So what does a notice consist of? It consists of a format, content, expression. Format includes a box, name of organization, word, notice, heading, date, and name of person with designation. This carries 1 mark. Then comes the content, children. Content answers the following questions. What is going to be organized? Where it is going to be organized? When it is going to be organized? How? And the agenda, why it is going to be organized. This part of the notice carries 2 marks. Next comes the expression. Expression includes, you know, the overall organization of your content, your ideas and thoughts, how relevant you have written, the grammatical accuracy. That when you write, you know, your content, your ideas and thoughts, they should be the least or no grammatical errors at all. And fluency includes how you are linking your ideas and thoughts. So this part of your notice would carry 1 mark. So now I would like to tell you, the marking of the notice is overall 4 marks. 1 mark for the format, 2 marks for the content, and expression we have 1 mark. Okay, and remember, notice is always written in the third person. Now children, when I say person, what do you mean by first person? First person means I and we. Second, you and your. And third person, he, she, it, they, and all the nouns, naming nouns. Explain you the format of the notice, how you are supposed to write the notice. See children, before you begin the notice, I want you to draw a block for the notice, right? All the three sides you can draw this block. Then the first thing is, suppose a question is given to you, imagine yourself as Ruchika or Rajesh and you are a student of St. Mary's School. Write a notice for the school notice board inviting the students to take part in the meeting. Okay? Meeting regarding the competition that is going to be organized in the coming week. The first and foremost thing is, you need to write who is organizing it. It is the St. Mary's School. So you are supposed to write here St. Mary's School in block letters, because this is the organization that is, you know, organizing the competition. Now suppose the name is not given in the question, about the school name is not given, then you are supposed to write ABC School or XYZ School. If the name is given as St. Mary's School, you need to write it as St. Mary's School. Then just leave a line, put the word notice in block letters. Okay, after that comes the date. You are not supposed to write the date as 18.5.2020. You are supposed to write it in the standard form, that is 18th May 2020. Then comes the heading. So what was the heading? A meeting. So we are supposed to write it here, meeting. Okay, then children, I'm just talking about that marks, how the marks are awarded to the notice. So the organization name, notice, date, heading, then comes the sign, name and designation of the person who is writing this notice now. See here, this part, notice, date, heading and the name and designation, it carries complete 1 mark along with the block. This carries 1 mark. And the next 2 marks, where we are supposed to be held or what is going to be organized, when it is going to be organized, I mean the date, okay? And then you can talk about where it is going to be organized, right? And why it is going to be organized and who can take part in this particular meeting. You have to mention all these points in detail, because marks are awarded for the value points that you are going to add in the body. So this part of it is going to carry 2 marks. When I say why it is going to be organized, why means what is the purpose of you writing this particular notice. So this carries 2 marks exactly, children. Now the next part of it, see, this is 1 mark for the format, 2 for the body. We have already covered 3 marks. There is 1 more mark left, and that 1 mark is for what? That 1 mark is for the expression. Expression, you know, includes the value points that you have, you know, added in your content. And that content, the value points, you need to see how well you have organized them, the vocabulary that you have used, and how grammatically accurately you have written. Okay, children? Plus, now the fluency is also included in this. Fluency means your language and the statements that you have linked one to the other. So for this, this part is known as the expression, and the expression carries 1 mark, children. So here we end up with the, this is how the 4 marks are divided for the notice, and after this is all done, we close the block from underneath. And now children, at the end I would like to tell you, now notices can be given. Lost something, you lost your tiffin box, or you might have lost your, you know, your pouch which contained the, you know, pens or some amount of money. Then they can be, you know, your scale or some important accessories. Maybe you have your card there, maybe your driving license, or anything can be there. Or you might have lost your briefcase, or you found something. So when you want those things to be placed, then the notices can be public notice also, it can be, or regarding some competition it can be, or regarding some events it can be, or the school is organizing a trip to some city, or not only this, or the school is organizing a picnic for the students. So this type notices can be given on any topic. So what is essential is how you are organizing it, how you're arranging your notice, and that, you know, and it's very easy and convenient for you to score full marks, that is 4 marks, if you are including all the value points in it. So I hope, children, now you will not be having any doubt in writing your notice, and so I wish you a good day and take care of yourself. That's all for today, and let's wait for the next lecture. And before departing, I would like to say, if you have any doubts in it, please kindly drop a comment in the comment box. That would help me learn that you have either understood or you are still in a doubt. You can ask any such questions. Okay, thank you very much.